It's a dangerous business, going out your door to your new project. You were supposed to make a shed for the electric wheelbarrow, and suddenly you have a hobbit hole. Here, you can see me working on the frame. The initial plan was something smaller, but I also didn't want to shorten the branches so you can see in the background. That's intended for the roof. Now, the frame itself is just notched together, and gravity sort of locks it all in place. The material is mostly Sitka spruce, some Norwegian spruce, and whatever scrap I had laying around. Now, since this was supposed to be a shed, I'd set myself a budget of about £50, and that includes petrol. But in the end, all I actually had to buy was a roll of plastic, so it actually came in on the budget. It was around this time I realized that if I raised the ridge of the roof a bit, I could get a small attic thing going on, and possibly alleviate some of my storage deficiency. Ugh, I really wanted to cheat and use the nails, but I was incapable of driving one through the branch. And what's worse, when I tried pulling the nail back out, well, you'll see. Luckily, the root of the problem had its solutions just beneath my feet, and having pretty much no experience working with the roots as a construction material, I gotta say, mighty impressed. Flexible when you pull it out of the ground, but settles firmly when dry. Just avoid knots with too tight of a curvature and choose knots that zeros the twist like a reef knot. Now, this is going to be the top ridge of the roof and the holes of the fastening. It will make more sense in a bit. Thank you. The ropes you see now are there just temporarily in order to squeeze the two ridge beams together. It wasn't heavy enough, so twisting the beams together worked better. The end's got a permanent metal band, whereas the inside's got rope going through the holes that were drilled previously. So, before anyone comments that that won't hold the water, I should point out that this is just the insulation layer, and that's why it's dirt side out. This was also the point where I started to realize that if I make a round door, this would totally be a hobbit hole, though I have yet to realize how stupidly impractical a round door is. In retrospect, I should probably have gone for a slightly less runny clay for the floor. Yeah, it was easy to level, but it took a month to dry properly. hat to check on the chickens, but it was just a stray cat. Here, you see me working on the fireplace, but I've included the possibility to convert it to a glass kiln in the future. I've been looking into upgrading from lamp working to glass blowing for a while, but never had the space for it. Well, until now, that is. And since I had to extend the chimney, I figured why not make a smoker as well. Here, I'm making what's going to be a marble for glassblowing. Not that relevant, but it had to be done before I close up the walls, otherwise there would be dust everywhere. Now, he is supposed to solder the lead frames, but my iron didn't have the power needed, so I got impatient and overdid it. And then I gave up and went for super glue. But from a distance, you can't even tell. I also made a small window, and then promptly stepped on the glass. But you know what? Super glue! As you can see, storage is being utilized. There's still some finishing touches that needs to be done, but for now, that's it. Thanks for watching.